Chapter 1325, Massacre. Space connection was different from spatial portals and channels. The latter two acted as bridges from one place to another. Space connection was something else. It could connect everything in two different spaces. For example, it could direct the flow of seawater from one space to another. This was why it was more advanced than the other two types. At this time, Li Kai has connected the spaces of the valley and maelstrom. He used the relentless power of the maelstrom to tear apart the sea god's foundation. If the foundation chose to defend the regal valley from the start, it would have been much more difficult for Li Kai to complete the connection as it would require much more resources and effort. However, the foundation was activated and all of its power was focused on the sea god's will in order to destroy the skeletal army. Because of this, the foundation grew lax on guarding the regal valley space, creating a hole for Li Kai. At the same time, the maelstrom space was immobile and rigid. It was countless times stronger than the valley's. This led to the power of the whirlpool channeling itself into the valley's space in a natural manner. Bang! Within a short period of time, the foundation was torn apart by the maelstrom. Without its power, the sea god's intent lost its strength and turned bleak right away. At this point, it wouldn't be able to protect the regal valley any longer. In an instant, the entire valley was sucked into the maelstrom. Under the space connection, everyone could see the valley appearing in the maelstrom space. No! The overlord pitifully screamed with his hoarse and nebulous voice. Clank! Crack! The entire valley was ground into little pieces by the maelstrom and sucked into its depths. The whole region vanished. Bang! The valley's space was destroyed as well, so the connection was severed. The maelstrom disappeared before everyone's eyes. At this point, what initially used to be the regal valley was now a void zone. Everything had returned to the origin. It was as if nothing had ever existed in this place. All traces of the valley and the Lothodi Sea God have been erased. From now on, these existences would only exist in legends. Li Kai returned to the war cliff using his spatial channel and casually cut it off. He stood in the sky with an air of indifference. Faces paled when met with the sweeping glare. It could be said that from beginning to end, Li Kai didn't personally attack the Regal Valley. He only controlled space in addition to the skeletal army, that was more than enough to annihilate the Regal Valley. A sea god's lineage disappeared just like that. There was no supreme master or imperial weapons, just exquisite space manipulation. Anyone who carefully thought about this matter would shudder in fear. After a long time, a great character murmured, Li Kai has mastery over space from cultivating a wondrous secret technique. Many cultivators struggled to regain their minds from this scene. All along when it came to merit laws, outside of fate and longevity laws, techniques were widely discussed. The more pertinent ones included offense, defense, and suppression. Of course, there were also techniques that involved banishment and sealing, but these were rarely used on the real battlefield. As for space controlling abilities, it was even rarer. Few cultivators were capable of cultivating these types of laws, most could only use it as a side branch and wouldn't focus on it as their main study. Li Kai's actions today were a real eye-opener. People got to witness the terrifying power of space control. One could even say that by grasping this art, one could sweep through all enemies while always being in a safe position. Controlling space was the same as grasping the fundamental basis of war. Someone murmured after calming down. Li Kai's display was very shocking, but it also filled people with regret because this was a rarely researched field. Li Kai returned and looked at the overlord hanging on the cliff. He chuckled and said, "Treating me as prey? You still think you are qualified to do so? You are no different from an ant in my eyes. I normally wouldn't bother dealing with an ant, but unfortunately, you lack all sense of propriety, thinking that an ant like you could hunt a true dragon. So not only did I crush an ant like you, I also put an end to your ant's nest as well." He paused for a moment before continuing. "I put you and your valley down not because we're enemies nor because you tried to ambush me. It was only because I found you to be an annoyance. Someone who chases after prey to satisfy your own perverted desires. If, say, you were personally going on a hunt using your own abilities to kill your prey, then I would find your courage admirable. Alas, a descendant of a sea god would choose to use such despicable means and even drag down the entire regal valley. Look now, I have done you a favor. You are finished, and so is the valley." He ended with a sneer. "Winner takes all, there is nothing else to say. Do as you will." The overlord was lost in despair with no other thoughts in his mind. Li Kai snorted, "You think you deserve that phrase? Someone like you isn't qualified to even enter the stage to be a competitor, you're only a common street thug at best." Li Kai's words were quite merciless, but no one questioned him. He had earned the right to say them. Moreover, most people didn't like the overlord and his devious nature. It was just that they were wary of the valley's power in the past, so they didn't voice their displeasure. Now, both the valley and the overlord were finished. Many were secretly applauding, but some felt a bit of regret since the entire valley was annihilated. Remember that this was a sea god's lineage. It must have countless treasures hidden in its trove along with spirit grasses and divine trees. If one could take down the valley, just these resources alone could have lasted them a lifetime. The overlord shouted with his dull voice, "Kill me if you dare. Killing you will only dirty my hands. The only reason you are still alive is so that you can watch the valley being destroyed." Li Kai smiled and looked at Ryuan. Ryuan smiled back. "If you wish for it, he can live here for several hundred years. To borrow his own words, a fate worse than death. He's only an ant, there's no need to show off my cruelty by letting him scream for hundreds of years." Li Kai chuckled in response. She replied, "If that's the case, then I'll send him off. It's about time anyway." The overlord didn't try to struggle. He slowly closed his eyes since the valley was destroyed and his game was over. Even if he lived on, he had shamed his ancestors as the sinner of the regal valley. To the hopeless overlord, death was no longer frightening, it was a type of relief. Ryuan flipped her palm and a wooden thorn flew out. It was the poisonous thorn that pierced the overlord's forehead earlier. After it was pulled out, the overlord rooted in the cliff suddenly withered at a speed visible to the naked eye. Next, his body turned into powder and dispersed into the sea. There was not the slightest trace of him remaining, a true death. The poison was true to its name, he returned to his roots. In the end, the victim would return to soil in their entirety. Li Kai turned to leave the war cliff after watching his death. However, in this split second, a ray shot forward from the same cliff where the overlord took root earlier. It was too sudden. There was no one there, thus this attack was completely unexpected. Having just killed his enemy, Li Kai was at his most vulnerable moment. Who would expect for someone to ambush him right now? This ray was even faster than a meteor or lightning. It instantly stabbed his back. It all happened too quickly as the assassin was only inches away from him. Yu Ruiyan couldn't even call out in time before the ray made contact.